In a previous post, I mentioned that experience drives both genetic activity and neural activity. In other words, your brain is not the source of experience, and your genes are not the source of your existence as a physical body. Let me repeat that. Your brain is not the source of experience, and your genes are not the source of you as a physical body mind. Let's just talk about genes for the moment. Consciousness, which is without form, influences gene expression through epigenetic modulation by modulating experience. The interaction between what we call the environment, our extended body, and the genome, the symbolic representation of the experiences of your ancestors. Epigenetics involves changes that affect gene activity without altering the DNA sequence, allowing the genome to adapt to changing experiences that we call environmental context. This process plays a crucial part in brain development and functioning and aging, impacting and modulating the matrix of experience throughout an individual's lifespan. Epigenetics, or I should say, epigenetic changes can form a type of cellular memory which can be transmitted to future generations, potentially influencing the evolution of consciousness expressing itself as diversity of experience. These changes are involved in neurogenesis, neuroplasticity, and the regulation of perception, cognition, emotion, and memory. Additionally, personality and self-awareness have been shown to regulate gene expression, affecting health and well-being, and individuals with higher self-awareness tend to have better regulation of gene expression, which is associated with improved physical, mental, social, and spiritual health. Meditative practices, which enhance self-awareness and induce states of inner silence, have been shown to positively impact gene expression. These practices can counteract stress-related epigenetic changes, promoting health and well-being by influencing genes involved in stress response and neuroplasticity. Consciousness shapes neural plasticity in several ways, primarily through experiences and mental practices that influence brain structure and functioning. Meditation and mental training. Studies have shown that meditation and other forms of mental training can lead to structural and functional changes in the brain. These practices enhance the connectivity between prefrontal regions and subcortical structures, crucial for emotional regulation. Such mental exercises can induce plastic changes in the brain, similar to skill acquisition. Neuroplasticity is also evident in learning new skills, so it's involved in learning and memory and acquiring information, which involves changes in synaptic strength, such as long-term potentiation. This process is a fundamental mechanism through which consciousness and experience shape neural circuits. Everyday activities simple everyday activities like engaging in new activities, learning a language, navigating unfamiliar environments can lead to changes in brain regions such as the hippocampus, which is involved in spatial navigation and memory. Conscious experience of stress and emotional states can lead to changes in brain regions like the amygdala and hippocampus, affecting their growth and connectivity, which in turn influences emotional regulations. These examples illustrate the dynamic interplay between consciousness, experience, genetic activity, and neural plasticity, reinforcing that your genes are not what created you. What created you was the desire for sexual experience or the desire for reproduction in consciousness. After that, it's all explainable. But everything begins in consciousness, and then genes become the agent, the mechanism for creating the body. And of course, gene activity or neuroplasticity are intimately related, in that gene activity, which is a result of epigenetic modulation of genes, the symbolic representation of the ancestors' experiences epigenetically modifying that further to change the neural landscape of the brain. So once again, experience is not generated in the brain. And your body is not sourced from your genes. Those are mechanisms. The source of everything is consciousness modulating itself as experience, which is both cognitive and perceptual activity, which in turn modulates gene activity and neuroplasticity. I'd love your feedback. Of course, Digital Dharma is now out, how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being. And you can also converse with my digital twin by going to digitaldeepak.ai, four languages, Hindi, English, Arabic, and Spanish.